and welcome to the Applied Deep Learning course 2024. In this course, you're going to learn a lot about machine learning and especially about deep learning and how you can apply it to solve challenging tasks that just a few years back have been considered extremely difficult. Welcome. My name is Alexander Pacher and I will be your instructor for this course. Before we dive into it, I would like to introduce myself briefly. I'm currently working as a software architect for eNote in Germany. We're trying to revolutionize digital sheet music and trying to bring the sheet music into the 21st century. I'm a musician myself and I'm singing in the a cappella ensemble Roots and Roots, as well as working as assistant conductor for the TU Wien choir. I did a PhD in the field of optical music recognition a few years ago, where I tried to teach the machines how to read music scores. So you take a picture of some music scores, let the machine process it, and then you arrive at some machine readable score that allows you to do a lot of cool things. As part of my PhD, I learned a lot about deep learning and applied many of those things. And in this course, I would like to share some of this knowledge with you. You probably are here because you read deep learning and you went like, woo, that's gonna be really cool. I'm really excited about this. And especially in the last recent years, there's been a big hype about artificial intelligence. So, you know, let's activate our deep learning powers and solve everything with machine learning. Well, if you think like this, you're definitely not alone. And in 2018, when I started this course, deep learning and machine learning were at the peak of inflated expectations. You can see it on this Gartner hype cycle of 2018, that deep learning back then was at its absolute peak. Everyone wanted to do it. It was super hypey. And actually, it hasn't changed much since. So all the years after that, say in 2020, you see again around 10 different machine learning AI topics appearing on this Gartner hype cycle, most of them somewhere in the innovation phase or near the peak of inflated expectations. And even in the most recent hype cycle, you can still see that a lot of these topics appear in this graph here. One interesting observation that I made was that topics related to trust, risk, and security seem to become more interesting now to many people and like as a general trend towards more responsible artificial intelligence. I would like to show you this short clip about inflated expectations, and it's not directly related to machine learning, but about CRISPR-Cas, the genetic synthesis that back then when it was discovered, many people thought would be able to give us anything and do anything that they want. And I would like to share this short clip from the comedian John Oliver.
Could CRISPR give us unicorns?
So, yeah, we're getting creative now. So there are examples of animals that have single horns in the middle, so like the rhinoceros has one at its nose, but there are other ancient rhinoceros that have it in the middle of the head. So anyway, I think that you could get a single horn on a horse by looking at horns in other species.
So it's in the realm of possibility.
Yes.
So even though deep learning is now already around for quite a while, I believe many people still have these inflated expectations. And what my goal for this course is to actually bring you a little bit into the reality, because sometimes people think you can solve anything that you want with artificial intelligence and deep learning, but reality is, well, not always. So I would like to answer a couple of questions as part of this course. What can and what cannot be done with deep learning? I would like you to gain hands-on experience how to pull off a deep learning project and learn how to use this incredible technology that has been discovered and developed in the last couple of years to such a great extent to use it to solve some really challenging tasks. And I want you also to understand how can you actually present results from such a project. The course itself is called Applied Deep Learning. And the reason for this is that actually you will do most of the work. So this applied part is at the center of this course. And what I mean is that I want you to focus, and this whole course rotates around one big project that you will be doing. There is some theory that I will provide to you in these online lectures, but you will be doing three different assignments: discovering a project, actually training some machine learning model, and then delivering that result to present the findings and the outcome of your project. You will also write it down in a short report and present it in the last two classes here to all of your fellow students. The project itself is pretty much up to you, so you can pick a topic. And I also prepared a couple of project types to at least give you a little bit of guidance. However, this is not a strict kind of barrier. There are sometimes projects that overlap between those types. But most importantly, I want you to pick a topic that is interesting to you, that is challenging, and ultimately also useful for you. I want you to pick a topic where you feel excited to tackle this thing, something that you always wanted to try, but you know, like maybe never had the time or the resources to do it. So this is your time. Feel free to pick a topic of your choice. The project types that you can choose from are bring your own data. So you can use an existing approach and collect a data set that you will be using with this given approach. The second project type is bring your own method. Basically flip those two things around. So you take an existing data set, there are already quite a few data sets that you can use, and try to develop your own machine learning model. Pick some existing baseline, try to improve it, try to push, you know, how far you can get with this data set. You can try to beat the classics. So you can implement a deep learning method and compare it to a non-deep learning baseline. Or as a fourth project type, you can actually try to beat the stars. This is the most challenging project type. And in this project type, the goal would be to actually improve the state of the art. So you will have to figure out, okay, which papers have been published recently? What is the current best results that you can get for this particular challenge, and try to beat that. How does grading work? This whole lecture is called an immanent lecture, which means your project is more or less your grade. So you're continuously graded, and you have five parts, as I mentioned before: the assignments, the report, and the presentation, and you get a maximum of 10 points each. So ultimately you will get up to 50 points. And I would like to point out that given that we're in the computer science department, other topics are also relevant that I will look at when I'm grading your project, which would be, you know, like complexity of the approach, obviously, but also code quality and, you know, readability of your code. So please also have this in mind when you submit your work. One thing that is written here, failure is acceptable. I would like to explain this a little bit. So if you aim for beating the stars and the baseline is say 80% on some metric, and you manage to train a model and you just reach 78%, I think this is something that I would say is a fair attempt on beating the stars and is okay as part of this course. Or if you pick a very challenging task and you figure out, I can't really solve it with deep learning as well as I wanted it to be, or some generative stuff where it's hard to understand, is this now working or not, or is it well enough? Those things are a bit fuzzy. And generally, if you do your project properly and document it, and I can see that you comply with the good practices of machine learning, then this is okay for me. These are the grades that you can reach and the number of points that you need to achieve at least to reach one of those grades. Please feel free to come back later to this part of the video or check it out in the slides if you want to know which grade you are going to expect by the end of this class. The assignments are the following. Number one, initiate. I want you to come up with a topic, to gather some data, research existing approaches, and ultimately plan the work that you want to execute for the rest of the semester. It should be something that, again, you should feel excited about. So feel free to roam around, gather some data. Most of problems that I find already have some data sets that you can make use of. Otherwise, I've also had a couple of students in the past who created their own data set from scratch. And this is a lot of effort. So actually, this is why the bring your own data is a project type on its own. For example, they investigated leather structures and they came up with a very clever way of collecting sample data to distinguish real leather from fake leather. The assignment number two is the hacking part. Here we get to the juicy details. So you will run some training on the models that you've decided to use. You will try to improve this as much as possible. However, you do not have too much time for this. So you will have, I don't know, like 2 months approximately for this part of the assignment. You should try to reach for as much as possible, but please be aware that time is limited. So around by Christmas or so, this will be over, this part of the project, maybe a little bit later. And then you should transition to the third part, to the third assignment, where you should build a small application that can actually run the model that you've trained and showcase kind of what you've done. Your goal is to actually ship it in such a way that anyone can understand what you did. A few words about the logistics. The entire course will be online. So you will receive weekly lectures on topics that I think are interesting and relevant for your projects. I will try to make them available as soon as possible, especially given that some topics will only be covered in later lectures. There are weekly Zoom calls where we can discuss open questions that arose from the kind of weekly lecture, so that we will still follow a certain schedule. Feel free to follow along, but if you want to skip ahead and already listen or watch a lecture that is further down the road, feel free to do that as well. In the end, there will be final presentations. So each one of you will have a 5-minute slot to present your work. And this will be as part of a pre-recorded video. So I will ask you to do pretty much the same what I'm doing now. Record a video of yourself presenting your project. And then in the last two classes, we will watch all of them together. Unfortunately, the capacity for this course is limited. There is currently a maximum of around 35 students. And the reason for this is that I want to give each one of you individual feedback and make sure you get the most out of this course. And if there are more people than this, I'm afraid that my time capacity is not sufficient to do this. This year, I have an assistant that will help me, so this number might still go a little bit up, but I'm, at least judging from the last couple of years, there will be more than 35 students that want to take this class. Unfortunately, some of you will have to wait till next year. And a word at this point, please only sign up if you really have the resources for this course. Expect that you will be working quite a lot of time on this project because I want you to have fun with it. And judging from the last couple of years, around 100 hours of time for this project is not unrealistic. It's kind of the average. Of course, some students do it a bit faster. Some even spend 200 hours on this project because they're so enthusiastic about it. But if there are more than 35 students, please be aware of that this course will take quite a substantial amount of effort and make space for other students that want to take the course and have the capacity. If you know already that your semester is already cramped and you will definitely not be able to finish this course. If you sign up for this course and are admitted to it, then you will receive a certificate by the end. If you drop out, you will get a negative certificate. So just to set this clear. There is in TIS a preceding course, the Deep Learning for Visual Computing. I think it's a very nice course. I took it myself quite a couple of years back, and it goes really into depth for visual domain of problems and also into some other topics that I believe are extremely valuable. So please take this course either as a preliminary course or as a continuation course to go into greater depth on that domain. A few more words about logistics. The projects that you will be doing, I want you to do on your own. Please do discuss with your colleagues about it. Try to get help, but ultimately hack it yourself. Code yourself. I strongly believe that when you do teamworks, projects with four people, that it happens quite often that some people do way more work than others. And in the end, I want every one of you to get those hands-on experience on the project and actually hack something useful for you. So there will be an online forum, an online platform. Please seek help and please help other students as much as you can. And you also unfortunately need to bring your own computing resources. I don't have a server farm that I can make available to you. So please use computers that have graphic cards in them. For most of the problems, this is something that you can definitely start developing with. If you need more resources, there are some online services, platforms as services, Google Colab, Paperspace, or also of course from Microsoft and Amazon, some machines that you can pay a little fee to use, or I know Google Colab definitely offers quite a lot of resources also that you can make use for free. Finally, I would like to briefly outline the schedule of this winter semester. There will be weekly lectures related to topics, and given that this year we do not have that many holidays that collide with the lecture dates, we actually have a few more slots, and this year I'm happy to say that we will offer or will try to offer two bonus lectures, one on graph neural networks and one on large language models. Please also take note of those deadlines for your assignments and make sure that you submit them on time. That's all for now, and I think it's time to jump right into it.